Hello and welcome to a bonus SWN podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. And why am I here at 8 o'clock in the morning on a Wednesday? Well, because of the kindness of Impact Wrestling and their upcoming UK tour, I got a chance to speak to former Impact Wrestling heavyweight champion Moose for the podcast. So we're going to talk about, it's like about a 10-minute interview. We talk about just coming to the UK, anything he wants to try out, and just some wrestling stuff. So it was very cool to speak to him about that. Some information about the UK tour Impact Wrestling's got coming up in October. Before we go, there'll be some information in the description below, whether you're on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or YouTube. So yeah, Impact Wrestling are back to the UK for the first time in years. They're coming to the O2 Academy in Glasgow on October 26th, Walker Dome in Newcastle on October 27th, HMV Empire in Coventry, October 29th. And then they've got an extra date, which I've written down, is October 29th twice. So I'm assuming it's 28th and 29th. They've got four-date tour, extra date just added for Coventry. Tickets are available. If you go to impactwrestling.com/events, you'll find out all the information and where to get tickets. They are as low as £35, and you can get a good seat and go see some wrestling. There'll be some meet and greets, I'm sure, at the same time. So enough about my rambling. We may have a little bit of a tail at the end, meaning me going bye-bye. But for now, this is my interview with Moose. We're on.
There you go.
Hello. You've got many of these today, I'm sure, Moose. I'll hopefully won't get you all the cliched questions in there, but there'll be a few, I'm sure. But
yeah,
I hope all's well.
I'm used to it. So,
Impact's come to the UK. Very excited to hear that. It's been quite a while pre-pandemic since Impact were here. One of the dates being Glasgow, so that's why I've jumped on as part of the Scottish Wrestling Network. Got here, got to talk about Glasgow, so we will do that. Basic, easy question to start off, just to break the ice. So you've been to the UK a few times now. Have you got any ever favoured memories of coming to the UK for wrestling?
Oh man, it's been so long, man. I can't think of anybody. I mean, it was like I said, the last to the last guy. It was a point in my career where I was going to the UK like at least 6-7 times a year. I was there so often, and I would stay for like a month at a time and do a tour. So, but as of memories, I feel like every time I step into the ring is a memory, and they're all memorable. Each and every match that I have in some way is memorable to me. So I would have to give you a list of every single match I've had to answer that question.
It's fine. People can go into Cage Match to find that out. That's fine. I'm sure there's plenty online as well that they can go check out.
Yeah.
So one of those times, though, so as I was looking up, I said 2019, I think pre-pandemic was the last time you were in the UK. So it's been quite a while. But before that, 2018 was the last time you were in Scotland. So that was so it was for ICW the last time you were here for the Square Go.
Yeah.
And Scotland, of course, is famed. I was speaking to Gail Kim and Alex Shelley in the press pass for the UK tour about the UK crowd and the Scottish crowd specifically. What was it about the Scottish crowd particularly? Do you think it amps your performance up? Are a bit rowdier? Just what your experience is with them?
I feel like just the UK crowd in general is pretty rowdy. I honestly couldn't tell you the difference between the Scottish crowd and the London crowd. I just feel like my experience from UK in general is the crowd there is way more rowdy than the crowd here in the States. But for as part of different towns in the UK, I can't really. It's been a while. I couldn't really answer that question because it's been a long time since I've been. I mean, was that 4 years? So yeah, I mean, I'll be able to answer this question next month when we are in 2 months when we come down. I'll definitely be able to answer who's more rowdy, Scottish or London or outside of Scottish area, Wales or all the different areas we're going to.
Absolutely. So we're speaking of.
Yeah, but my memory is so shot. It's been a while, man.
That's all right. I'll take it.
I can't even tell you. I couldn't even tell you that who I wrestled when I was there in 2000. I would guess was it Joe Coffey or maybe Drew Galloway, one of them? One of those two?
That's the exact two I've got written down. I've got Joe Coffey and Drew Galloway. their opponents. But I remember, of course, Impact being aired in the UK through the Dazen, I think it is. I can't remember how it's called. But I remember maybe specifically through things like World of Sport Wrestling and Five Star and stuff like that when it was on
TV
as well.
I remember doing World of Sports a couple of times, and I remember doing Five Star also. But I don't remember the year that or what area in the UK it was. I don't remember. I think on one of those shows I did, I was in a tag match. I know with Rey Mysterio. I just can't tell you who the other two. Maybe was it me, Rey Mysterio, and Rob Van Dam versus Grado?
I think
maybe
you're on
Grado
Team
was
Grado.
My team.
Yeah, Team Grado was.
Yeah,
on.
I don't, it's, yeah, but yeah, to answer your question, that was probably one of my memorable matches because I do remember the guys who was in it, but I couldn't tell you who we wrestled though. I just remember the crowd being. It was a real packed house, and I got to wrestle with Rey Mysterio and Rob Van Dam, which two of the biggest legends in all the professional wrestling, right? So, yeah.
Absolutely. I think you may have seen my notes, because we seem to be segueing through my questions very, very easily when it comes to it. So yeah, October 26th, O2 Academy in Glasgow, that's the kind of one we're going to focus on just for our audience. Grado was confirmed for that UK tour, one of the guys that you teamed with in Five Star, and World of Sport. I think you were in a battle royal with them somewhere in that show.
Yeah.
Just for curiosity's sake, you've wrestled... faced people from the size of Rampage Brown to just the X Division guys as well. How, in your head, how do you prepare for an opponent like a Grado in comparison to a Joe Coffey or a Drew Galloway? Is there a different mindset you have there?
For me, no. I mean, I come to the mindset the same, no matter who my opponent is. I mean, obviously, you know Grado's, what Grado does in the ring is a little bit... different than what everybody else does. And I think the main part when you step in the ring with Grado, you have to keep your straight face on because he will do some comical things that make you want to laugh and be not serious. And that's part of his tactic, you know, to catch you slipping. But other than that, like, you just have to be focused. You have to be 100% more focused when you're in the ring with Grado because, like I said, he does a lot of comical things to get you off guard, right?
Absolutely. I mean, the other thing we've got, you recently re-signed for Impact Wrestling. Was this before you were aware of the UK tour? Was that something that temptation of being over for UK to the UK for the first time, was that a factor in re-signing for Impact?
No, the Impact UK tour kind of, I don't think anybody knew about it. It kind of hit us all on surprise. Me signing back with Impact was just something I wanted to do. I felt Impact was the right place for me and a place that made me happy and had a lot of things still I wanted to accomplish here and a legacy that I am building here. But yeah, Impact management don't really tell us where we're going or new places we're going to venture off to. We kind of get the memo when the crowd get the memo. So we're kind of like surprised about some of the places we get to go to when you guys hear about it.
Amazing. So it's pretty much as soon as we get the press release, that's when you're finding out as well. That's wild, especially with things like the recent Down Under tour in Australia, where you faced Joe Hendry over the Digital Media Championship. Again, was that just the fly when you find out, everyone else found out, and you were getting to go to Australia?
Yeah, I mean, they tell us to keep this dates open, but they don't tell us, oh, keep this dates open, we're going here. They just tell you keep this dates open. And then when they announce it to the world that, oh, these dates were going to Australia, that's when typically when we find out.
So speaking of that, with Joe Hendry, of course, you're a victim to one of his music videos. I've heard many people that I've spoken to about Joe Henry's videos that is kind of the same as Impact telling you you're going elsewhere, or going somewhere anyway, sorry, elsewhere, going to the UK or Australia. So you don't really find out until the day of. Of course, it's one of those times.
I didn't know much about the video until I saw it live on TV. But I will say that say this. I've seen the videos he's done about everybody else, and I probably got it the easiest, I'll say. Yeah, because some of the things he said and about other people was like, oh my God, I would kill him if he said that about me. But I mean, with me, I mean, his was still funny with mine, but it was like the worst thing he said was, I'm a dancing moose. Wow. That's such an insult. I dance. But yeah, some of the other things he said about other people was like I said, I got it the easiest.
I've seen some rough ones, not just in
Yeah.
Impact, but the ones he's done in the UK as well. He's he finds tried to hit a nerve. I think he may have tried to take it easy on you because you're such a massive human that
Yeah, I mean, he probably didn't want to, he didn't want that to be his last video, so I think that's why he took it a little lightly on me.
Absolutely. So speaking of the UK tour, I mean, you've been away for 4 years, and last time you've been in the UK. Do you keep up to date on how the UK scene's going? Is there anyone in particular that you've got an eye out for that possibly would be brought in during one of the four dates that you'd want to get in the ring with?
To be honest, I haven't kept up with the UK scene that much. I think part of the reason because a lot of the scene got bought out by WWE, so there's not that UK wrestling since the pandemic hasn't been the same. Just because of that, WWE went on a big buying out market where it was buying out every talent, right? So because of that, once that happened, I kind of like stopped watching a lot of the wrestling in the UK because it wasn't really a lot of wrestling there. But now that it seems like the indies are coming back to its own, I think I'm gonna start catching up to see who's the hot and new wrestling talent. I'm sure we're gonna have a bunch of guys, some of the guys, some of the good guys there in the UK being a part of our show, so I'll get to check them out during our show.
Before all that, though, you do get to face a British wrestling legend, even though he doesn't compete in the UK so often at Multiverse, when you face Zack Sabre Jr. in amongst a tag team match. Again,
Yeah.
someone very different as an opponent, between a very technical wrestler. Is that something that you train extra for? Is people that you try and grab to learn a little bit more technique, or do you just stick with the game plan?
I just stick to the game plan. I mean, that will be different than what I'm normally used to wrestling. But I mean, I've wrestled guys like Jonathan Gresham before, and they are built from the same cloth. You know, they're real technical guys. But the question is, has he wrestled somebody as strong and as quick and as athletic as me? That's the question you have to ask. So he's in the same boat as I am, wrestling guys that he's wrestling a guy who he's not used to wrestling. And as far as fame as me, I'm wrestling a guy who I typically don't wrestle all the time. So we're in the same boat. So we'll see what happens next
Excellent.
week.
And so just a nice kind of nice round off question, because I know you're going to be very busy with these today, even though you're used to them. I don't want to just labor with loads of peppering you with questions. You talk about your memory not being great, so this could be an absolute dud of a question to end on. But do you remember from your trips over any favorite UK food, any favorite haunts that you hit, like Nando's or anything like that?
Oh yeah, definitely Nando's. Nando's is definitely the one. I think the whole roster is probably going to be taking a trip to Nando's at some point during this UK trip. I'm looking forward to it.
And the UK, the TNA or Impact should be getting a black card then. I think that's the if everyone's going to be there. And as Joe or Grado or that tried to convince you into things like deep fried battered Mars bars or any Scottish delicacies.
Oh no, that's something we'll probably get into when we're down there. That stuff we don't plan for. It's like a spur of the moment thing. So we'll see.
Excellent. Well, great. I can't wait to. Hopefully, I'll be down for October 26th at the O2 Academy. I know you've got the shows at the Walker Dome, HMV Empire, and Coventry. Just a date just added. But I'm looking forward to seeing what we do. We're still a long way away, so things may change. You may have your opponent announced for one of the dates. We don't know. But thank you very much for taking the time to speak to me today. And it's been an absolute blast. And I'll give you a little bit of couple minutes rest before the next person.
All right, thanks.
Great. Thank you very much.
All right, bye.
There you go. Just a quick one with Moose. It was so exciting to speak to him. I had bunch of notes, a bunch of questions, and we rattled through them really quickly. But we got really good stuff there. I'm so glad I got to speak to him. And again, thank you to Impact Wrestling for facilitating the chat. Like I said, I'll just give you all the plugs again. Go to impactwrestling.com/events and you can find out all the ticket information for their UK tour coming up in October. O2 Academy in Glasgow on October 26th, Walker Dome, Newcastle, October 27th, HIV Empire, Coventry, October 28th, and the 29th at the same venue as well. So get your tickets, go see some Impact Wrestling. The wrestling world is on fire right now. The UK is got all these amazing events coming up from all corners of the US and into Japan as well, coming over to the UK, which just goes to show that we're such a hotbed. Once more, we're starting to rebuild again after the pandemic and NXT UK and all that kind of stuff that Moose was talking about a moment ago. But if you enjoy what we do, this is the first time listening to us because Moose is on. You can find out more about SWN, swnscotland.com, or on social media on Twitter or X or whatever it's called, at Scott Resnett. On Facebook, I think it's at Scott Resnett as well. Instagram, all that kind of stuff. We're just at Scott Resnett on everything other than the website, which is swnscotland.com. But no, hope you've had a good one. Hope you enjoyed that little bonus chat that we had there with Moose. And have a good rest of the day.